Praise the Lord, and welcome to Pearls of Wisdom International Women's Ministry Midday Meditation. I'm your host, Bishop Melvita Harewood. Today's topic, Matters of the Heart, and our scripture is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 6, verse 45. I will be reading from the New Living Translation. And Jesus said, "A good person produces good things from the treasury of a good heart, and an evil person produces evil things from the treasury of an evil heart. What you say flows from what is in your heart." Let's set the scene. People had traveled from far and wide, from all different places, and these people really didn't have anything in common except they came together to hear the Master teach. As Jesus looked out at this diverse crowd, he may have been looking for some common ground, something that they would all understand, and finally he chose the following analogy. He knew his listeners knew apple trees consistently bore apples and grapevines bore grapes. They knew that an unhealthy tree would bear unhealthy fruit. Once he knew that they got the picture, he then began to compare the human heart to a tree, and the words that we speak he likened to the fruit that that tree would produce. He explained that what grew in a person's heart was evident by what came out of their mouths. You see, no matter how smooth or honey sweet your words are, they cannot hide an evil heart. The fruit's true nature will always be revealed. Let's think about what Jesus said. Let's put it in perspective. Talking about our physical hearts here, your physical heart may be hidden from view, but its condition is revealed by how well your body is working. A healthy heart regulates your blood flow throughout your body, and you will be a healthy individual. With an unhealthy heart, various symptoms may manifest and reveal problems. An unhealthy heart can also lead to fatality. When the Bible speaks of the heart, it is not speaking of your physical heart, but of your will, your volition, the core of who you really are. This metaphorical heart works in the same way as the natural heart. If you open your heart to the Lord, and if you will continually allow Him to cleanse you with His grace and forgiveness, your words will reveal that. Your speech will be full of grace, mercy, and compassion. Your conversation won't carry any hidden disease that would be potentially harmful to others. Instead, it will be filled with encouragement, praise, gentleness, and truth. Pay attention to what you say. Your words will reveal the true condition of your heart. Make sure to line up your will with the words of the Lord. This will keep your heart healthy. Our pearl of wisdom today is from Psalm 119, verse 11. David said to the Lord, "I have treasured your word in my heart so that I may not sin against you." Hide God's word in your heart, remembering that what comes out of your mouth begins in your heart. Join me again tomorrow when we will continue discussing the important biblical principle of purity. Remember, invite Jesus to purge the deepest corners of your heart so that your speech will be purer and your life transformed. Have a Jesus day. You have been listening to Pearls of Wisdom Midday Meditation with your host, Bishop Melvita Harewood. POW International Women's Ministry is an outreach ministry of Bethel Life International Fellowship, headquartered in Quebec, Canada. Now, I'm excited, so before I leave, I want to take the opportunity to invite you to tune in to Bethel Life International Fellowship's broadcast on Blog Talk Radio tonight. The program is entitled Let's Talk About Jesus, and it begins at 7:30 p.m. Tonight, we will be beginning our study in the book of Acts. So if you're interested, please feel free to log on at www.blogtalkradio.com/BLIF network. Again, that's www.blogtalkradio.com/BLIFNETWORK. God bless you and see you tomorrow.